Clover, and today I'm going to be doing another book review. And this book is going to be about Tom Gates, Genius Ideas. I love this book. Sorry, I haven't brushed my hair and cleaned my teeth. But yeah, I'm just going to do a video right now because I feel like doing a video and yeah, it might get me more likes today. So, this book looks really long, right? But it isn't, because they're short. They're really short and it's easy to read. Not hard words, like something you don't know. For example, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, you don't know how to say that. Some people do though. But like, see, they're like all easy words and they're also really funny. And then like each title, they're like in the end, I read this book. Just let me, do something. And then, so it's like this. In the end of this book, it says, another genius idea. And genius idea. So like, the title can relate to the book, of course. That's why you would name it. Can't name like a book, like the dragon, and make it about a fairy. Can't do that because it doesn't really make sense. And like, I like it how it like, it's a tieback ending. So it's like genius ideas, and then like another genius idea in the front of the book. So it's like tieback, you know what it is? It's like what happens in the front and then what happens in the back. So it's like the same thing, like in the front and in the back, like the beginning and the ending. It's like twisting together. It's like one part here and then this other part there. So like, I like that type of endings because they're like pretty cool. And like, also, they also have pictures and they're really funny too. Like every book, there's like this guy named Tom Gates, and then he's like, always like being funny and like and stuff like that, and like sometimes he's just being like weird too, but like not too weird, but like funny and weird. I like it, and like this is really cool too, because like it's just like sometimes it's good stuff, sometimes it's bad stuff happening, but like every time at the end of the book it's always a good ending. And I like good endings. I don't like bad endings. For example, like, but I never got my chips back or something like that. I don't like that. I want like, yes, finally I got my chips back, like that. I like those type of happy and good ending stories. And one of them is this. So I really like this book too, and I would rate it 4.3. Because I really like this book. And it's really fun. Really fun to read, and you can read them when you're bored. Like I always, when I'm bored and like nothing to do, so I just like read a book. And one of them, I've read this and it changed my whole life. I like it a lot. And also, I recommend this book for maybe 7 to 12, because I think you should read this book, but like for ages under 6 or 6, like can't really read this like long book. There will be like one, wait, like that, and then they're like, what? I don't know how to say this word, so like, but like for people like me, 9, we can read this book easily, and they make sense. And then, like, when stuff makes sense, you, like, all understand it. And then you're like, oh, I see. And then if you don't understand a joke, when you see it makes sense, you're like, oh, I get it. So funny. Like that. So, like, it's good you can read a book. But the most important thing is that you have to understand what it means. So, like, yeah, like, this book. You have to be like old enough or like smart enough to like read this whole book and not get bored, and know what it means and like it makes sense in your brain. So like I like this book and it makes sense to me and I really like it and it's really, really funny and I recommend you reading it. So that's the end of my book review and thank you for watching and listening to my video. And